Welcome back to Manchester with the Rude Man Farming Simulator 2015, and we're going to do some farming. Been away for a few days, so I don't remember where we left off, so I'm going to have to take a quick look around and see what we were doing. It's summertime. There's lots of stuff going on. I've been doing some traveling, so I come back and got to figure out where we left off. So, let's just take a trip around town and see where our equipment was left and what it was we were doing. Okay, obviously this guy was doing some windrowing, so let's get him going. No course loaded. What field is this? This is field... Oh, this is one... Okay, this is a new field I just purchased. So, let's go ahead and... We're doing straw field work. Where's my field 11? Do I even have it? Oh, are we on 11 or 12? Oh, we're on 12. Never mind. Let's move it up while we're thinking about it, though. I can put it in straw field works. All right, so now it's in the proper pew. The proper Pepe Le Pew. We'll grab that. Let's start the tractor up. And let's get to work. Go man, go. All right, next. These guys are sitting there waiting for harvest. I think I've got them all clean. This person evidently was going to be doing that field when that windrower is done. I think he's far enough into the field that we may be able to start this forage wagon up. Let's take a look. So, the question was, have I done a course to take care of this straw? Okay, I have straw field 12, but I don't have straw field 12 to any kind of bunker. So no, I need to do that. Let's start that. This poo field's got me creeped out here. Ow! Oh my god! Was that ditch that deep? I guess so. I didn't think I'd need a helmet for driving one of my tractors, but maybe I do. Alright, we're going to start right here. Right here. How about right there? Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to do one of those, and which is the grain transport load at start. We're going to do that. Start the course. And we're just going to take it to that farm right over yonder. So we're just going to pull right out into the street here. And here we go. Today is Tuesday, June 23rd. At the time I am recording these, I've been traveling for the summer. We had a big family reunion for Father's Day in Wheat Country in the middle of Washington State. This week it's 110 degrees there, so I came home to the coast. It's a lot cooler. And I'm getting ready to do, at the end of the week, I'm getting ready to take off again. We're going to go spend a week down in Bend, Oregon, where we have a condo. What was that? Something beeped at me. Oh, shoot. I came through the wrong way, didn't I? Oh, geez. Let me see here. Let's stop this. It's that straw pile right there I want to line up to. I think it will be easier if I come around this barn. So, yeah. So here's the plan for this week. I'm going to try to get enough episodes put together so that you won't miss anything. And here's the trick to that. I have a new farm that I've been making episodes on. And this is over the last several months. I haven't actually recorded a video on that farm for about a month. But I have four or five episodes ready to go on that farm. So the plan is when Nebraska is done, which may be this week, then I'll just start uploading the new farm. So maybe by the weekend you might be seeing a new farm. I'm not making any promises because I'm not very good at keeping them. So, and if you want proof of that, just ask my wife. My wife could tell you a lot about me. Wouldn't all be good either. Right, now I got to be careful because I don't want to hit that spout on that mixing station. But I want to get in close enough that I can hit these triggers. And then pull out. And again, I don't want to mess with that thing right there. Oh, by the way, I had a subscriber, which if you give me a second, I'll look it up. I had a subscriber that's very observant that noticed that in the last episode when I bought what I thought was a potato harvester for $500,000 was actually a beet harvester. So if you look up above, in the last episode when I left, I had 3,300,000. Now I'm down to 2,800,000. Well, that's because I had to sell that beet harvester and buy my potato one. So I actually do have a potato harvester now. So that was a costly mistake on my part. I suppose I could have cheated and cheated some money in to replace it, but I took the hit. I was going to say that's the kind of guy I am, but it's not really the kind of guy I am. It just happened to be the decision I made in this particular instance. Okay, so let's stop this. We're going to name this Straw Field. What did I say it was? Oh, man. What field is this? 12? Straw Field 12 to Farm 2. All right, let's do it. Is it 12? Oh my God, is it? I think it is. Okay, let's stop that course because we're gonna do a combination course, which is gonna be, wait a minute, before we do that, let's take this and pop it up into Straw. All right, so we're gonna do Straw Field 12 right there. We're going to come out of that, go back in, and do Straw Field 12 to Farm 2. Go back in here, and, well, maybe we better line it up a little better. And then drive the course. And hopefully this is going to work. I think it might. All right. Let's get on with business. Let's see what else everybody's doing. Okay. We need this guy. We need this guy. Is this? This is the 620. That's the 620. We got to get this guy going. Oh my God, we got a lot of stuff to do. I forgot how busy we are on the farm. Oh, man, we're just really busy. Let's take a look at the new equipment. All right. Okay. Okay. You know, we've got a little bit of money. Let's spend it. Let me see what we're looking at as far as fields. We've got enough fields. We bought all of these fields. We got enough fields for now. Let's see if we can replace. I want to try these the Red Baron. I bought the Red Baron. That's this big monster beast, and replace those the ones we had. So let's buy one of these. We've actually got enough money to buy two, but okay. Let me think. Let me see how many of the tippers do we have? The big boy. We have three. Okay. Let's go to the garage. What do we have in tractors? We've got two of those. And we have three trailers. Okay. Oh, I already bought one of those. Ooh. Ooh. Okay, so now we have four tractors of those big monsters. Oh, no. That's okay. That's okay. That's okay. That's okay. All right, let's get out of this completely. All right, so here's the thing. We still have $2 million. Let's sell one of those cases. No, wait a minute. Get two of those. Yeah, let's sell one of the cases. The quesadillas. We'll sell one of those. Which one are where are we at? Garage, garage, garage. Let's go to the garage. Let's sell one of these. Well, actually, we're gonna sell both of those because we're gonna replace them with the Red Baron. So yeah, let's sell both of those. That probably made a big mistake right there. And let's go back. We're gonna go to mod. Yeah, I probably just really blew it. I probably should have kept one of those just because we need another big tractor. Ah, damn. Oh well. No worries. We're loaded, right? Okay, so let's get these. This guy. Look at the size of that. Look at that. The canister on the side of that. Look how big that sucker is. My God, that thing's a monster. So, why is he just sitting there? Listen. I mentioned this in the Nebraska video. I bought some of these in Nebraska. And I started one of them up and I said, "My God, I need one of those little JCB golf cart tractors to use as a starter to start this thing. I think it would probably fit inside there." Okay, let's get him going. Now, was he on a course? He was on a course. So you continue on. There you go. Isn't that a monster? Look at that. All right, what else have we got? Let's start this one up. Now, if you remember in that one episode where I bought one of those Steigers and it started wheelieing all over the place, I'm hoping this one doesn't do that. If it does, I'm going to be sorely disappointed. Look at that canister so big you can't even see the road. What is that all about? I think you got coffee on the left and tea on the right, or that's caffeinated and that's decaf over there. And I'm not quite sure where I need these tractors, but I need to hook one of them up to a seeder and get these new farms that I have seeded. Lizard on sale. Well, what the hell do I want a lizard for? I've got a Kenworth. I'm driving through this coffee. All right, where did I leave that that other cedar at? And as soon as I got a chance, I'm gonna see what the animals are doing. I think they're all ready to go, except for the fact that I don't have any earth fruit. All right, we have a cedar right here. Oh, come on. You telling me I can't hook up to this machine? That's impossible because I've already got one hooked up to it. I just gotta line this tongue up just right, I guess. There we go. All right, now what fields have I got planted? I've got 2, 3, and 6, and they're, what do they have on them? Okay, 2's got wheat, 3 has potatoes? 6 has wheat. 7, have I done 7 yet? No, haven't done 7. 1 has got what? 1 has got, okay, I'm doing 1 in wheat. All right, because I need, that's right, I needed wheat and potatoes for feeding animals. So, right, let's do that. In the meantime, let's do... Well, we'll do the rest in... We'll do the rest in wheat. Why not? Okay, now let's see. Do we have courses set up for field 7? All right. Fert fields. Grass harvest. Wait a minute. Seed, there we go. And there is one for field 7, so let's get going. I love the way these things idle, too. Listen to the sound of this tractor. It just sounds like a big, proper tractor. I just hope it does the job. And we won't find out till we get our harvest ready. All right, so what do we... Okay, so we do have the cedar set up for wheat. And let's drive the course. Now, I think I only have 2 cedars. But they are big. Of course, so are the fields. All right, I don't like those ridge markers. Turn those off. Don't like those. Don't do that. Don't like it. All right, let's get on with life and see what else we've got going here. Okay, this guy doing his job. This guy, he's doing his job. Well, it looks like he's working. He's awakened. Come back for another load. Oh, this guy. God, I tell you what. I need a checklist. I got too many jobs to do. One of them's gonna have to be for washing this truck and trailer, because it is filthy. Now also, I need to take a look and see where, wait, going the wrong way. Let's take a look at the animals here. Okay, chickens, sheep, 110%, they're working good. 36% wool, cows. We've got milk stockpiling up again. They're all looking good. Everything's looking good there. And now beef. Oh, God, look at the slurry piling up. I don't think I ever got to the... Yeah, I did. All right, so the only thing we're missing here is grain and potatoes. Pigs, again, grain and potatoes. And then the second pig farm, grain and potatoes. Not much I can do about that, so there it is. We're going to go get some slurry off the cattle farm, which is on farm number 2. I don't think there's any sense in washing this truck until we're done. So, we're gonna go. I'm pretty sure that everything that looks like dirt on this truck and trailer is not necessarily just dirt. I'm pretty sure it's slurry. So, if there's still some that's moist, I'm gonna kind of sling some at Sean as we go by. Here, have a little slurry on me. I don't think I've got Enterprise doing anything. I got plenty of grass, but I can't remember, so we'll go take a look amongst all the other things I'm doing. And let's see, where's the slurry output here? Over on the side, was it? I'm not quite sure. Yeah, really, I'm not sure. Can't be there, they put something in front of it. Where is it? Is that here? It is. It's right there. Okay. It just looks different on every dang farm. Let me look at this, though. Let me look. Where are we at here? Has this one got... Is that what that is right there that tells you how full the slurry tank is? Wow, that thing will hold a lot of slurry. If that's what that is. Well, that's good to know. Oh, he's here. All right, while he's doing his thing, there's Starship. There's thing, I don't know what thing that is. That must be thing 1. Okay, and then, oh, we've got that. Oh, look at that, all that silage to work. Got all that silage to work. Where's thing 2? There's thing 2. Where's your equipment thing? Is it back at the farm? Whoa! Traffic jam. Where's his equipment at? I don't know. Well, we'll have to go find it, I guess. I don't think it's real high priority, but I wonder if it's on farm number 3. I'll bet it is. Somebody's in traffic. What's that about? Oh, crud. How long's that been sitting there? Probably the whole episode. Probably the whole ding-dong episode that thing's been there. Yep, he's done. Alright. The turning radius on these isn't big enough. They struggle. Look at that. Alright, he's full. Let's get him on the road. On the road again. We're slinging poo on the road again. Sometimes I feel like a monkey. You ever see monkeys in a zoo sling poo at you? Those nasty monkeys. Everybody thinks they're cute. They're nasty. You gotta put diapers on them little things. Depends for monkeys. Why? I don't know. It depends. So I hope everybody's having a good summer, because depending on where you live, summer comes and goes pretty damn quick. Where I live on the coast, we don't get a lot of real hot weather, so our summer only lasts about a month or two, a month and a half maybe, compared to other people's summers where it's 80 and 90 degrees for 3 or 4 months. You know, we may get about a week of 80, 90 degree weather. The rest of it's like 60. It's been 60s. It's gotten up to, let's see, I got a thermometer on my wall here. Outside right now, it's almost 74, so it's been a warm day for us. That's kind of a scorcher day for us. It's been in the 60s, still getting down to 40-something at night. We don't generally get real hot weather till about August, sometime maybe late July. But every year's a little different. So, open up. There you go. So, anyway, I hope you're having a good summer. And if you got kids, I hope they're in summer camp so it's giving you a little bit of a break. I used to love summer camp. Not for me. For my kids. You know what one of the problems was with this tank right here? When you pull up to fertilizer and fuel and everything, I'm using an Xbox Spybox One controller, and you hit the right bumper button. But on the slurry tank here, I have to hit the A button, so I get confused. I have to kind of watch for that little icon over there to see if I'm lined up. Okay, well, there's this thing. There's this guy. He was working his way. He's working his way back to me. Oh, crud. Oh, crud. I gotta jam up over here. Jam up, jelly tight. Old Tommy Rowe song. Stop this. Get out of the way. I don't know, of all those fields I bought, if there's anything else that needs to be. I don't think so. So I think this guy's job is done. I may have to buy a third seeder. I got the money. There's probably no reason why I shouldn't. I could just leave a seeder on each farm. That would work, wouldn't it? Oh, jeez. Don't hit that trailer. Oh, that was close. Yeah. Oh, I think I did hit the trailer. My bad. My bad. Sorry. Oh, yeah, I did. Moved him a couple of feet. He's kind of a mess over here. I mowed this once. Didn't do any good. All right, I'm going to plop him there. Let's go to the store. Why not? And get, what did I say? A sewing machine? I in the I know my mind just went whew. The Nebraska episode, the last Nebraska episode, when I was traveling, I saw several of these pieces of equipment here out in the fields where I was, right in the middle of Washington State. It's grain fields as far as you can see for miles and miles and miles. Hotter than hell, 110 degrees. All right, so we got one of those. Let's grab our other tractor. Oh, God, I still got to get him going. I tell you, there's just not enough time in the farm day to get everything going. And I mentioned this also in the Nebraska. I keep mentioning Nebraska. I did an episode last night, so it's all in my mind. But I did mention, like, my son was making a comment about YouTube videos, mine in particular. And he said, most of the YouTube videos I watch, the YouTubers are only doing 10 and 15 minute, videos. And I looked at him and I said, well, on the farm here, if I did a 10 or 15 minute video, I'd get my equipment started and halfway to the field before I'd have to end the video. So I wouldn't get any farming done, that's for sure. Oh, thank God I didn't move that tractor, because he's already right here to pull this cedar. Uh-oh, I kind of jumped the gun on that one, didn't I? I had the tractor moving before he actually got started. He didn't even have time to get... Well, let's see. I'm gonna do a couple fields of barley. I don't need that much wheat, do I? I'm just feeding animals, and they don't take very much, I don't think. All right, where am I at here? I need to go maybe this way. I'm trying to think of where I bought those fields at. I think I've already done field 2 and 3. I better make sure. Doggone it. Can't remember what I did from minute to minute. Yeah, I did. So 2 and 3 I've done. I just bought this guy. We'll take him. Let's see, I bought him here, I guess. We'll take him over this way and do 12, 11, 10, and 9. Work our way down to 20. Right. Sounds like a plan. Oh, quit jumping around. I have to take you off-road. Yeah, I try to keep my videos around 45 minutes for the farm. And like I was telling my son, I said, yeah, if I did a 15-minute video, imagine. I'd go around, start all my tractors, and the 15 minutes would be over, and I'd have to just go and turn them all off and say, okay, I'll see you next episode. Now, it really depends on what kind of videos he's watching. If he's watching role-playing games or anything like that, you got to have a longer than 20-minute video, longer than 15 minutes. If he's watching some guy that's just doing, you know, game reviews, maybe a quick tutorial, you know, something like that, then they can be pretty short videos. A lot of my tutorial videos are only 10, 15 minutes, depending on what it is that you're doing. But if I do an equipment review or a game review, those are usually 5 or 10 minutes. They're not very long. I'm going to go to the end and work my way to 12, I think. Just start over here, I guess. Okay, get the big piece of equipment in the field. Let's take a look. We're gonna do seeding. This is field number 9. So let's set a course for that. Okay, we're in field number 9. We're going to do, why is there a user for field 9? I don't, what happened there? All right, going to do 15 meters. We're starting in the southeast. Southeast. And we're going to be heading west. And let's start that up. We're going to do seed field 9. I didn't do a seed one already, did I? Well, let's take a look. Seed. No, 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 no seed 9. There is now. Alrighty. Okay, here we go. Button it up. Look at that guy's a working fool, isn't he? You go, you go. Alrighty. And drive the course. Somebody just finished work. Who was it? What? Oh, I don't. brand new cedar. There's nothing in it. All right, fine. Be that way. See if I care. God. Who just finished work? Somebody just finished work. Who was it? Had to be one of the cedars. That guy right there. He finished. Okay, stop and delete that. Somebody needs refilled. Is it this one? No, not this one. What field am I now working on? Okay, I just 6 and 7. Just finished 7. Okay, I moved down to 4. I was talking about goals for Manchester, you know. Just owning all the land isn't a very good goal because I already almost have every piece of land owned in the short period of time I've been playing. So that's not a good goal. And I mentioned something to somebody that they said, hey, on your Manchester goal, maybe you should own every field and get $5 million. And I thought, well, wait a minute. I only own maybe, well, before I bought those fields that I just bought, and if you remember, I just bought 12, 11, 10, and 9, I just bought those. So before I bought those, I only owned less than half of the fields, and one harvest I made $3 million. So I don't think $5 million is a good goal. It'd be too easy. So it had to be like maybe 15 million or 20 million or something like that if I was going to go that route. So I don't know what kind of goal I should set, but I think on this farm it should include the animals. So we'll have to work on a goal, or I could just play it till I'm tired of playing it. That would work too. Okay, let's see. Start recording. No, we're not start recording. We already have one. Pretty sure. Field 4, seed field 4. So I shouldn't have come out into the field. Didn't need to. Okay, we're gonna go with that. And here's the funny thing, I didn't need to take, what's he doing? I don't know what he's doing. I didn't need to take this guy to this field. I don't know where my equipment's at. I'm gonna have to find it or have it delivered to the farm. But I should have left him on farm number two, because now I need him to fill that cedar. But they go pretty fast. They go lickety-split. I hate that word. I don't know why I keep saying it. They go very fast. Put it that way. One of these days, when I'm feeling in a randy mood, I'll tell you why I hate that word. Some of you may already know. But it's not good for mixed company, so I'm not saying anything. Alrighty, is that, am I close enough? Whip, 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 stop it, stop it, stop it. Oh, I just took out my rig. I'm not even gonna look. I lied, I'm gonna look. Oh, I don't see any damage. It's okay. Okay, now I've gotta get... Gotta get these guys going, don't I? Oh, I need that tractor over there. This guy. I'm assuming that I have not fertilized any of the fields that I've seeded so far. I think I'm gonna replace these blue tractors with JCB tractors. Although, I should probably keep one of them for a front end loader. I need a front end loader for the wool pallets. Alright, let's fill it up while we're here. Speaking of wool pallets... Oh, speaking of everything, let's see. I need to check, see how these things are doing. Better turn the HUD on. Well, it's got 67% ration in it. Lucky. Let's go see how the wool's doing. Oh, I still got lots of room. Oh, look, I've got all of this room over here. Yeah, but look, we're stacking it up. Good, 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 good. Let's go back to our tractor. He's full up. I'll try to do this in a systematic way because I can remember what I did. So I'm going to start at field two and work my way around, I think. In the meantime, I need to get this guy started and get fertilizer in him. Oh, look! He can reach the fertilizer clear from over here. God, that must be a big trigger. I didn't realize that. It must be a huge trigger. I'm kind of running out of time in this episode, so I don't know if I'm going to actually start these guys. I think I'm going to line them up on the field, and then when I come back next episode, I'll just start them up and get them to work. That sounds like a plan. Gotta love it when a plan comes together, because it doesn't very often. Not for me, anyway. Ow. That hurt. Dang it, chipped another tooth. Seriously, that hurt. Oh, God, didn't get any better that time either. I don't remember if I have, where's my garage? I do have, okay, I've got a front end, whatchadinger, and it goes to which tractor though? Let's see, it's good for the, okay, so it's good for this one. Well, I guess it's good for either one, but I think that's the only one I've got. Let's take a look. Yeah, that's the only one of those tractors I have. So, I'll just got to remember to keep one of them for the front end loader. My thingy, my boot, my doodle. Alright, so we're just going to grab this guy and kind of park him out here. Sure, why not? We'll just kind of park him out here. And do I have these in... Oh, he's done. Ow, that hurt. Well, that was the swoosh. So we got him set up on two. We'll take this guy and set him up on three. And then we'll go around and see how we're doing on the seating. I'm trying to be organized, but it's not very easy for me. Oh, potatoes. So we'll leave him here on the potato farm. And let's see, we've got... Oh, no, no, no. Don't do that. Stop. No, don't. God, I don't know what I did. I'm hitting buttons that evidently are set up to do things that I don't use. I don't use the keyboard very much. I use a controller. And I was hitting keyboard buttons and wasn't the right thing to do. Okay, we'll leave that in because you gotta know that I'm not perfect. All right. Anyway, I was trying to figure out which buttons I had set up for looking around. See? Look, I did it again. There must be a cruise button set up. And it's supposed to be a button for me that runs between, like this. See what I'm doing? I have a recorded button, but every time I push it, it makes that guy want to drive. But anyway, all right, I'm gonna close the episode here because I'm just rambling anyway. We'll continue on with what we're doing in the next episode. Hope you're having fun on your farm. I'm having fun on mine. And I'll see you in the next episode.